So today we are going to learn use case analysis. And this is chapter number 4. I hope every one of you have the book now, or still if anyone is having a problem getting access to the book, or you know, so far not purchased the book, let me know. Everyone is having the book? You can say yes or no in chat. Because you need to refer in a lot. That's good, Anthony. Thank you. Good, Eric. Good. That's wonderful. Anna, you have the book now? Okay, only 3 responses. That's good. So let's go into the system development life cycle and let's see. So under planning, we have done system request, feasibility analysis, and project plan work and staff. After doing this, we go in the analysis to requirement determination. And last week we talked, you know, we discussed about different methods, 5 methods, and how you can see the requirement and how you can observe, how you can interview, how you can document analysis and many and 2 other things. So you understood requirement determination. Now let's go further. Just so today we are going to learn purpose of use case in analysis phase of the system development life cycle and various parts of use case and the purpose of each part, how use cases contribute to the functional requirements, and describe how use case information and development of test plans, explain the process used to create use case. So this is what we are going to learn. What is use case and use case style? This is the outline of the today's. Before going into use case, I would like to tell one thing. As you can see my, you know, course syllabus, I would like to go on course page and I would like to show you some so that can you see this quiz 1?
Yes.
Now it is open and you have 2 attempts to do these 20 questions. And you can, you know, last attempt, latest or last attempt will be scored. So the first attempt will be null and void, you know, only the second attempt will be counted. If you are not doing second attempt, the only first attempt will be counted. It is available from today and it will last till February 11. So you take your time, understand your, you know, the things and do by yourself, you know. So you have enough time, I think almost more than 2 weeks I have given. So you can do as per your convenience, sufficient time. And so this activity everyone has to do. And this is the exam that will pop up on February 9 only. So we will be keep talking about this. So this is quiz is started. Do as per your convenience. Sufficient time is there. So no problem that, you know, you can be flexible. Now let me go ahead with, I hope you can see my screen now.
We see the quiz screen.
Oh yeah, so now.
Oh, there it goes, yeah.
So how many of you know what is use case? And did you try in other courses? 373. Okay. Use cases represent how system interacts with its environment, basically. And it illustrates the activity that are performed by the users and the system responses. So activities produce some output results. So how user or human computer interaction, this is also part of that. But how users can interact with the system and how it gives the output. How an external user trigger an event to which the system must respond. So whatever event any user trigger, system must respond. The moment you do anything, what is the response of the system? So in event-driven modeling, everything in the system can be thought of as a response of some triggering event. Each use case describes one main set of activities of the system. So main activities of the system. Role of use cases, here you can see, express and clarify the user requirement. What is the requirement of the user that can clearly demonstrated by use case? Define the expected interaction between user and system. So basically user-system interaction. Use that interaction to more fully describe functional requirement. So this is also used extensively in analysis phase, often JAD sessions, interview and JAD sessions. Text-based use cases are easy for the user to understand. So basically this is based on text and flow easily into creation of process models and the data model. So these are the elements of use cases: basic information, precondition, normal course, postcondition, exceptions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 items. So basic information, name, priority, actor, description, trigger, and type. This comes under basic information. Precondition, defining the state the system must be in before the use case commence. Normal course, the major steps, inputs and output is in execution of the response to the event. Postcondition, define the final product of the use case. And exceptions are error condition leading to unsuccessful results. So this is what put into use case. And we are going to see the templates, we are going to see the examples. Use case has name and number and brief description. So this is must, every use case has this information. The priority may be assigned to indicate the relative significance. The actor refers to the person, another system or hardware device that interacts with system to achieve a useful goal. So look into that, actor is not only the individual, but also system, another system. Or hardware device that interacts. So basically actors, if you look into different actor network theory or where actor are the human, but here in this system, another system, individual or hardware device. The trigger for the use case, the event that caused the use case to begin. So trigger is the, basically a beginning point from where the use case begin. Events trigger can be external and temporal. So let's have a look of. This is the basic information. So what is in this basic information? These are the points and this is the sample. Look into this. Use case name. Name is always there. And request a chemical is the name of the case. It has ID number, if you can see my mouse cursor, ID UC2. And priority means it is high priority, low priority, moderate priority. So what is the priority? That is clearly given here. Now come under actor. As you know, what can be there in actor? Individual or people or, you know, systems, another systems or hardware. So who are the actor? Non-chemical applicator. So this is the actor here in this. And this is just an example. You can see the complete in the book. Here the description is here. The non-chemical applicator specifies the non-chemical need for a job by entering its name or ID number. The system satisfies the request by reserving the quantity requested or the quantity available and notify the chemical supply warehouse of the pickup. So this is the description related this. And now we come to the trigger from where the, you know, the use case begin. A non-chemical applicator needs a chemical for the job, for a job. So this is the triggering point. Therefore, this case is started and this is external or temporal. So this is external because it is, you know, outside non-chemical applicator. So this is the basic information, and in your assignment also you have to make this kind of thing. You have to come, you know, you have to study the case. You have to come with basic information in this form. So this is very simple. If you read this slide before, what comes in basic information? Name, number, and description. Priority, actor, trigger, and event. So this is basic information. If this is clear, I'm going further. So, you know, you have to read the case carefully and identify these items from the case, from your own thinking. Now we come to the precondition. So preconditions are the LCA identity is authenticated, means what is the full form? Non-chemical. A non-chemical applicator identity is authenticated. LCA has necessary training and credentials for of file. These are the precondition before going into this. And the chemical supply database is up to date and online. So when you can do this, you know, these are the preconditions that, you know, chemical supply database is up to date, LCA is authenticated, and, you know, necessary training and credentials on file. So before this, so for example, you know, before using Canvas, you know, I think you are, you know, before starting any course or any EW admission, I think they give you the orientation, how they use the, how Canvas is designed and all. So once you are trained enough, you get into the system, or you are registered for course. But you know, I'm having this problem. I'm teaching MBA online decision science courses, and many of the students don't know even how to install the software, how to install the Minitab, how to access virtual lab, how to do, you know, how to interact with Canvas. And, you know, instead of teaching the subject matter, I'm teaching them how to install, how to do basically all the basic IT things I'm handling from my side, because they were not trained. So preconditions is like, you know, everything is set, then you just go and interact with the, you know, this is the basic information. And for this use case, the preconditions are these. Normal course, the major steps that are performed to execute the response to the event. So this is basically a normal course or process that, you know, normally has to perform when things are done. So request, so this is, you know, you can see under 1.0, these are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are the things. Request a lawn chemical from chemical supply warehouse. This is the request. Under this, what are the activities? The LCA specifies a chemical needed and quantity needed. So this is the heading is this. Under this, this is the quantity and chemical. Under two, the system lists chemical and quantity on hand from chemical supply data store. So if a quantity on hand is less than the quantity needed, the LCA specifies the quantity he will take. Purchasing is notified of chemical shortage. So this is like, you know, you also interact in similar manner on any baby store. Suppose you want to buy something from Home Depot or any store. The similar way you go under this, you can see the quantity, you can, you know, if whatever you can purchase, rest can be shipped. So basically this is, you know, step by step. Course, normal course, first thing first, then what should be the second, what should be the third, you know, how it will appear, how it will process. The third thing, the system gives the LCA chemical pickup authorization for quantity request. So whatever, you know, the LCA, the system gives the LCA. After that, the system notifies the chemical supply warehouse of the chemical pickup. And the fifth is system stores the lawn chemical request and chemical request database. So this is five steps process under, you know, basically under request lawn chemical from this. This called normal course. How, you know, one by one, how the steps are performed, they are under normal course. So basically, again, when you are doing your assignment, you have to think clearly, you know, what comes first, you know, what comes second. And after that, you know, post conditions. What is complete when this use case ends? So pre, normal, and post. So there are four things. The lawn chemical request is stored in chemical management system. The chemical pickup authorization is produced for the LCA. The chemical supply warehouse is notified of the chemical pickup. And purchasing is notified of chemical outage. So this is, you know, what is complete, you know, when this case ends. So these are the four things which are appearing here. So similarly, you have to write based on your thinking. And now we come to the exceptions, which is the, you know, error conditions encounter while performing use case steps. So not normal branching in design logic leading to unsuccessful results. So basically, when you do any things, you know, there are some errors in the system or, you know, that does not perform. So similarly, these are the exceptions. So exception number one, which is E1, chemical is no longer approved for use. Basically some, you know, chemical which are not allowed to use. Under E1, the system display message the chemical no longer approved for use. So that is the case. The system asks the LCA if he wants to request another chemical or to exist or exit. This can be there. The LCA asks a request another chemical. The system starts normal course again. The LCA asks to exit and the system terminates the use case. So basically, what do you understand from these use case elements, which is, you know, basic information, precondition, normal course, postcondition, exceptions. So these all come under use case. So this is the sequence of use case. They are performed in sequence. No single use case should be too large. Important to define initial and ending state. So basically precondition, postcondition, precondition, postcondition, precondition. So basically, you know, obtain a chemical, you know, here precondition, postcondition. The second is request a chemical, pick up chemical. So basically, it can be divided into multiple, you know, small use cases. Therefore, it says use case and often performed in sequence. No single use case should be too large. Full addressed use case format. So very thorough, detailed, and highly structured. Add new section including alternative courses, branches in logic that will also lead to successful conclusion, inputs and outputs for steps, summary inputs and outputs. So you can see full dressed use case format. Look into this. Normal course, for example, request a lawn chemical from the chemical supply warehouse. And you can see the LCA specify the desired lawn chemical, and the system verifies the chemical approved for uses. The system display, look into the fifth part. The system asks the LCA to confirm the request for quantity needed or the quantity available. This is alternative. Here you can see information for steps, chemical name and ID, list of approved chemical, quantity of hand, and you know, quantity needed, request confirmation. And after 6, 7, 8, you can see the system gives LCA chemical pickup authorization and request. So basically, this is full dressed use case format. This is the format that, and alternative courses, there are alternative courses also, and you can see the information for steps. For example, here, the LCA asks to take the quantity available. Whatever quantity is available, that was asked, you know, and 4A, you can say the system give LCA chemical pickup authorization for quantity available. And, you know, the last, you can see the ask to cancel the request, 2B. So this is full dressed use case format. Then you have to full dressed use case format, summary inputs, sources, output, designate, and destination. Chemical name, ID, list of approved chemical, chemical quantity, quantity needed, request information, confirmation, request quantity, and all. Sources from where they are coming, LCA, lawn chemical supply database, lawn chemical supply database, LCA, LCA, output, chemical pickup, authorization, and destination are chemical supply warehouse, chemical request, and purchasing. So after this full dressed use case format, use this format when user are not closely engaged with development team. Project has high complexity and high risk. So when do we use the full dressed use case format? When user are not directly involved with the development team and it has high complexity, high risk. Test cases need to be fully described. And when you need to describe it fully, then use it. Remote collaborating team need detailed share understanding and user needs. So this is the simplified use case format. Can you see this? And yeah. This is exactly what you are asked to do in the assignment of this week, which is, you know, for example, write use case on one sheet, or you can split into 2-3 sheets as per your, you know, content or text. Use case name, request a chemical, ID, UC2, priority high, low, medium, whatever, actor, LCA, description, it's an external trigger, when it starts, you know, a lawn chemical applicator needs, for example, summary inputs, sources, output, destination, normal course. All the courses are listed here, and you know how information for steps. So this is the typical format that is used for use case, simplified version. on one seat or on, you know, and then. So in assignment, you are requested for this week to do this thing. Use case practice tips, use grateful refinement, concentrate on describing the user objective in working with the system completely and accurately. So basically, what is the important thing? User's objective working with the system. So basically, you should understand, you should think, you should, you know, imagine how users or objective is working with the system. And then, you know, you will be better. Therefore, you know, this is system analysis design means you have to have the complete system understanding when you are designing a system. If you miss one side of the system, then, you know, certainly it is going to result in, you know, not accurate output or not, you know, results will not be good in simple words. Keep both audience in mind, business users as well as system developers. So when you are, because this is the document that is used by users and developer, so both can understand, you know, if you write too much technical, business user will not understand. If you write too much, you know, business side, you know, system developer will not understand. So you have to keep the balance in that, you know, keep in mind when you are doing. Create use case only when needed to clarify what the system must do from the user perspective, not needed for simple events. So create use case when needed to clarify what system do from the user perspective. So use cases and functional requirements. Use cases are useful tool to clarify user requirement. Use cases convey only the user point of view, not including processing details behind the scene. So basically only user perspective, transforming the user view into developer's view through functional requirement is one of the system analyst key contribution. So if you can transform this into the developer's view, that is the most important thing. And derive functional requirement from use cases, tell the developer more about what the system must do. So how system will act, react, interacting with user, that will be from the developer's point of view. So here detailed functional requirement use case content, for example, normal course, used to create more complete and descriptive functional requirement. So this is, you can see the system cell allow the LCA who is logged into the chemical request system to request one or more chemical. The system so cell allow the LCA to specify chemical by event entering its ID number and name. So what system must do? What is the functional requirement? That is what is listed here. The system cell notify the LCA if the chemical is no longer approved for use. The system will prompt the LCA for quantity of the chemical needed and all. The system cell prompt the LCA to exit the system or make another chemical. So this is the system functional, you know, things. Creating use cases. It has four steps. Identify use case, identify major step within a use case, identify elements within steps, and confirm use case. So creating use case, what are the steps? Steps 1, 2, 3, 4. Activities, typical question asked in each steps. Identify the use case. Start a use case report from each use case by filling in the form. In the name, description, trigger. If there are more than 9 use cases, group into packages. Ask who, what, when, and where about the use case. What are the major tasks that are performed? What triggers this ask? You know, what is the triggering point of this use case? What tells you to perform this task? So this is the first step. Identify the major steps within each use case. For each use case, fill in the major steps needed to complete the task. Like ask how about use case, what information form report do you need to perform this task? Who gives you these information forms reports? What information form reports does this produce and where do they go? How do you produce this report? How do you change the information on report? How do you process forms? What tools do you use to do this? Third steps is for each step, identify its trigger and its inputs and its outputs. Ask how about each steps? How does a person know when to perform this step? What forms? So basically, you know, and the last is confirm the use case. For each use case, validate that it is correct and complete. So ask the user to execute the process using the written steps in use case. That is, have the user role play the use case. So basically, these are the four steps in order to go ahead and creating the use case. We have used the typical question for as is model. What are the same question can be used to be model, but they would be phrased in the further future tenses. What should be the, you know, so you can think about, you can craft your own questions based on this. Now, create a set of use case for online university registration systems. So in your own understanding, you know, registration system, who asked this course? Who is the triggering point for university registration system? What do you think about online university registration system?
So you're asking who the trigger for it was?
Yeah, for online university registration.
It would be the staff, right? Because it's the staff who's examining the courses.
Do you think staff is the one or?
Or the student, like, sign up for classes?
Yeah, you know, staff does, you know, other things. They approved the register, you know, basically you go and you register your courses and you pay the money basically, and they approve and they have other things, you know. For online university, for example, suppose there are many online universities across USA, let's say Grand Canyon University, Arizona University. If I go, that system is right there on you know, who starts, I'm the first person. Okay, I decide to pursue the course with Arizona State University or, you know, Grand Canyon University or any online university. So I'm the one who decides and start interacting with the online university registration system. So that is the trigger point. Basically, the student or, you know, prospective student start doing the interaction. Create a set of use cases, you know, you can think from this point of view. The system should enable the staff to each academic department to examine the course offered by their department. So basically, you know, that this is internal side, you know, that, you know, each academic department, what course to be offered, you know, add, remove course, change information. It should permit a student to examine currently available courses, add, drop courses. Department staff should be able to print a variety of reports. So this is a very simple, because you are interacting, you can practice this because you can think of this system. You can understand all the steps in this system because you have been doing this from last 3-4 years, I believe. And you know how it works. What are the activities where you have the problems, where you observe the problem, where the workflow is stuck. So you can, you know, understand the entire this way. And you can just, you know, for practice, you can just start filling this, you know, all these templates are right here at the, you know, so it's a practice for you. And, you know, and it is important in order to understand, you know, go ahead in the system clearly. So this is your practice part. So this you can see. So practice student needs to enroll in the course. So this is trigger point is a student who wants to enroll in the course. And you can go slide by slide, you know, since we are in different phase here. So you can, you know, look into that, who is a primary actor, and, you know, you can see the everything right here at the last end. So this is about use case. Do you understand what I am expecting from you to do in this?
Yes.
That's great. That's great. If this is clear, everyone is clear about this?
I do have one quick question.
Please.
On the importance, on the important level, the low, medium, or high,
mm-hmm.
do we get to choose the importance level, or does that depend on the description?
So basically you can see, you know, it will be in description. You can understand the importance of that and you can decide it is high, medium, and low. For example, the student enrollment is very high because that is the main business for universities. So if they don't get the customer or they don't get the students, so this is a most very highly important, you know, this use case has to be properly, you know, explained so that the system can be developed, system can be made that can be very user friendly or student friendly, I would say. So sometimes it is given in the description of the question, if you look into the assignment. But if you are doing let's say you are developing any system, then you have to decide how important it is for every business or any business. What is important? Customer. I mean, if there is no customer, there is no business. Therefore, it is given very high or high priority. Is it making sense?
Yes.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
So, yeah, because, you know, those people are in development and developing, you know, things, or they can, you know, decide based on the opinion, based on the, you know, customer. How about this? They can interact. They can see the complexity and importance of the. Now I'm going a little bit further. So just a minute. Chapter. So I'm just sharing the, I hope you can, assignment. Can you see the screen of chapter 4 assignment?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Here, you know, this is the question. Create a set of use cases for the following system. A video store runs a series of fairly standard video stores. Before a video can be put on the shelf, it must be cataloged and entered into video database. Every customer must have a valid ABS customer card in order to rent a video. Customer rent videos for 3 days at a time. Every time a customer rent a video, the system must ensure that this customer does not have any overdue videos. If so, the overdue video must be returned and an overdue fee is paid before the customer can rent more videos. Likewise, if the customer has returned overdue videos but has not paid the overdue fee, the fee must be paid before video can be returned, rented, sorry. Every morning, the store manager prints a report that lists overdue videos. If a video is 2 or more days overdue, the manager calls the customer to remind him or her to return the video. If a video is returned in damaged condition, the manager removes its form, from the video database and may sometimes charge the customer. And so here, you know, you have to create a use case, and here actors interacting with the system, customer, and store manager. So this is the very simple question that, you know, you have to go through and do this week. So basically, what you are going to do, you are going to do the same thing, basic information, pre-condition, post-condition, you know, normal course and error part. So you are just going to design based on your understanding of this case, a small case. Here it is, you know, hint is given. Actors interacting with the system, one is a customer, one is a store manager. So how many cases will be there? You can think. So when you read the chapter number 4, you will understand clearly about this. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yeah. That's clear.
Yeah.
Now, should I go in chapter 5 or just let it be? Because, you know, the next part would be DFD. So you just do this assignment and then we will go DFD in next week class.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Okay. Okay. Because, you know, once you understand that this use case part, we'll go DFD next week. Okay. Any other question anyone is having, please let me know. If no question, I would like to say have a good night and have a nice productive week ahead, you know. See you next. You. Okay, bye-bye.
See you next week. Bye.
See you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.
I did have a quick question.
Yeah, please.
It had to do with last week's assignment.
Mm-hmm.
Due yesterday.
Yeah. Go ahead. So the last week assignment was your only observation. It doesn't have a technical thing. So last week assignment was, you know, just, you know, you have to observe the, you know, the person who was there to observe in a restaurant. I forgot the name of the person who was just, you know, as a, he went to a restaurant to observe just for 2 hours and where he made the mistakes, how he made the mistakes. So it has no technical thing. You want to know the answer or you want to know the feedback on your assignment?
Let's see.
You can share, you know.
Yeah, because I did see the submission comment. I don't know if it's possible for me to redo it and send it again.
Just a minute. That is previous week, you know, not last week. That is, you know, I think, you know, I haven't graded yet.
Oh, which is, oh, okay.
I'm going to write the comments in, you know, this observation I can give. But, you know, the last week was very easy assignment where you know, you have to just take out the weight from that. You have to put in this and simply calculate simple arithmetic. And I think 3-4 students. So I have to create something new for you, because, you know, we discussed the solution in the last, and somebody said 112 and 134, something I think we discussed in the last class, and it was not expected to. So there, you know, I think some, that assignment that is the problem that, you know, the calculation is not correct, probably.
Oh, okay. Okay. So I just have to wait then until
yeah.
Then. Okay.
I'm going to, you know, I'm not going to penalize you. I'm not going to do, but, you know, I'm just finding alternative course of action so that, you know, you can learn basically this, you know, you can use the appropriate number.
Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Alrighty.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.